itakuwa ni kutafuna, itakuwa ni kukula, kuliko kukata rasilimali, kazi yako itakuwa ni kusukonda, sababu ulitwa jina.
Kwa ulipewa jina. Alo hiti.
Wato hi.
Wato hi.
Kenywa. Moreu. Wamonyota. Praise be to God. Ha? Nagani ingine. Kenywa. Kenami. Morage. Karibu wakikuyu tuwa kwa hapa. Omo simba.
Omo simba.
Okol. Meaning what?
Mvua.
Mvua. Sasa wewe ndiye nomino. Shindwe sana. Praise be to God. Praise be to God.
Tabu.
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 We want to declare to you all the names.
Majina yote.
That your hate has called you.
Mayo wayo.
All the names.
Majina yote.
That your enemies called you.
Majui wale.
I want to declare today.
Nataka nitangaze.
You will never get a child because this clan, they don't get children. And if they get children, they die before they are 85. Those are the names that your father gave you. Praise be to God. When you have a father, he will change your name. He will change your name. That is why it is important. And when you have a father, tell your father the name that your mother gave you.
Gina.
Tell your father the name
Gina.
That the midwife gave you.
Ambayo
tell your father the name
Gina.
That your teacher called you.
Ambayo
tell your father the name
Gina.
That your head has called you.
Waliyo kuchukia walikupatia.
Amen. Amen. Praise be to God. Somebody misunderstood you.
Mtu alikosa kuelewa
na wewe. Spoke a curse upon your life.
Hata kunena la.
You need a father. To invoke those words. You need a father. To change your name. In the name of Jesus Christ. A father will give you a name.
Baba atakupatia jina.
A father will give you a name.
Baba atakupatia jina.
In the name of the father.
Katika jina la
Baba. Will stand in Jesus mighty name.
Na hilo jina
tusima. Pray to God. The name
majina kutoka kwa
ukoo
na maadui
will not exist.
Hayata
pa. They will not dictate your destiny.
Hayata amua hatima.
When you have a father.
Wakati una baba.
In Jesus mighty name. A father number 4.
Baba jambo la 4.
A father will give you a garment.
Baba atakupatia vazi.
Genesis 37 verse 3.
Mwanzo 37 mstari wa
5. A father will give you a garment.
Baba atakupatia vazi.
Can we read all of us one to go?
No. Because he had been born to him in his old age, and he made a richly ornamented robe for him.
I didn't hear you. Can we read all of us? You know, when you are reading, you are putting faith in the word of God. You are making that word be born in your spirit. You are making that word active in your life. Amen?
Amen.
Praise be to God. Want to go loudly. Now Israel loved Joseph more than any of his other sons, because he had been born to him in his old age. And he made a richly ornamented robe for him. A father will give you a garment.
Baba atakupatia
vazi. A father will give you a garment.
Baba atakupatia vazi.
In fact, another translation says,
tafsiri nyingine inasema,
that a father give him a special gift.
Baba akampa kipawa special.
Our color code.
Ya koti la marangi mengi.
Praise be to God.
Bwana asifiwe.
A color code.
Koti lenye lilikuwa na rangi
mengi. And it was a special gift.
Na ilikuwa ni kipawa.
From my father.
Kutoka kwa baba.
When you have a father.
Wakati una baba.
You have a gift. gift. And a special gift. I want to imagine that maybe it was the 70th birthday of Joseph. Praise be to God. And it was in his birthday. And
after
the father decided to give the son a special gift. And it is a gift of life. A gift of life. Because the Bible says that Joseph was loved more than other brothers. This was a special love.
Utakuwa na kipawa cha kipekee.
And this special gift.
Na kipawa hiki cha
kipekee. It's a gift.
Ni kipawa
that will identify you.
Ambacho kitakutambulisha.
Among others.
Kati ya wengine.
Praise be to God. Why the brothers were jealous of Joseph?
Kwa nini ndugu walikuwa na
kipawa? Because of the garment.
Ni kwa sababu ya koti.
The ornament.
Na vipawa.
The beautiful robe.
Kipawa cha
ajabu. That the father had made for him.
Ambacho baba alikuwa amemtengenezea. Na sasa ndugu zake wakiona
maybe it was during Christmas.
Kare kakoti. Na ilikuwa Christmas.
Maybe it was during Christmas.
Na ilikuwa Christmas.
And in Christmas.
Na Christmas.
The father buy gifts.
Baba ununua vipawa.
Amen. To the children in the house.
Kwa watoto kwa nyumba.
Praise be to God.
Bwana Yesu.
For the girls.
Kwa wasichana.
They are both the maritas, the gorofa thing, eh?
Ile ya net.
Praise be to God.
Yeah.
Amen. And for the boys, they are both the t-shirts with their polo colors or whatever.
Nah,
amen. Praise be to God. So during Christmas, a father will give gifts to his children. And there was this Christmas. And all the sons were given gifts. Unfortunately, praise be to God. Unfortunately, it could not fit them. Praise be to God. I remember when my sons were young, and I could buy them gifts, or the father could buy them gifts. And because they are not twins, they were both different. Praise be to God. But when you go and put those gifts there, it was so frustrating to see that when you bought this gift, you know this is for Manasseh, and this is for his brother Ephraim. And when the gifts were put there, you realize Manasseh is getting There is something I don't calculate well here.
Yeah.
Okay. Manasseh is attracted to red. Oh. And Ephraim is attracted to black. To blue or to green. Amen. But now,
lakini,
you got now to make sure.
Lazima uhakikishe.
Unatotia ile kibawa. Bona pewe sifa. Sachi na. Kila mtu atalindi.
Atalindi.
Sasa ni wewe baba ama mama ujipange.
Ujipange.
They all wanted this one. Unfortunately, it could not fit any of them. Because Joseph was younger than his brothers. So he wore the jacket. And he was Salvation. That is why you hear people, you are praise of God, telling you,
Satan.
Praise be to God. It's a thief. But what he does, he steals the wrapper that wraps your bread and
runs
with it without knowing that you are not interested in the wrapper of the bread. You are interested with the bread. You are interested with the bread. I want you to let you know. Don't you ever be discouraged. Never be discouraged by your enemies. Because the king that is in you, nobody can snatch it from you. That's your gift.
Power chako.
Will do what? Will make you stand before great kings. Amen.
Yes.
It will make you stand in great places. Because the gift that comes from a father, nobody can snatch it from you. The garment that the father had given to Joseph, as much as the brother took it, they could not. They try to destroy it by smearing it with the blood of an animal, taking it to the father to make him feel pain of losing his beloved son and giving him the code
na kumpa lile goti
as a bitter memory,
kama kumbukumbu la machungu,
to keep him in pain all the way,
kumweka katika machungu kila wakati,
but the gift of the Father,
lakini kipawa cha
that Joseph had received,
ambacho Yusufu alikuwa amepokea,
went with him, and at the end of the day,
katika mwisho
wa mambo, made him become a prime minister,
kumfanya afanyike waziri mkuu.
Amen. Haibu usichagai na shetani. Eta chukua tukaratasi. Lakini mkate ni yako. Praise be to God. Haibu usikibishana na ye. Akinaona shetani ya pita kwako amekugonga na chukua karatasi ya mkate unakibishana na ye.
Wachana
na ye. Keti chini kula mkate yako. Amen. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. That is why I don't believe in people who keep on saying what the devil has done.
Ndio sababu siamini wale watu mkaa kutangazia watu vile shetani amewafanyia.
Praise be to God. Yeah. What the devil has done, it is non-material.
Kile shetani amefanya,
whatever he done is nothing.
Chochote ambacho anafanya,
always remember,
kumbuka kila wakati,
any action of the devil,
kitendo chochote cha shetani,
it is taking that wrapper away from you.
Ni kukunyang'anya kukungia akikuacha na mkate.
Praise be to God. Praise be to God. Always when you have a father,
kila wakati ukiwa na baba,
you have a special gift.
Una kipawa special.
A gift of love.
Kipawa cha upendo.
A father will love you.
Baba atakupenda.
Even when you are away.
Hata wakati.
The Bible says that the father
baba
loved Joseph.
Alimpenda Yusufu.
Even when he had gone away.
Hata wakati aliambiwa
Jacob loved his son.
Alipenda mwanawe.
He was told he had been killed by an
animal. Akaambiwa ameuawa na mnyama.
But he loved him.
Lakini akaendelea.
He loved him all the way.
Alimpenda.
Until when they reconciled.
Baka wakati
walipata. In the later days.
Siku za baadaye.
In the later days.
Siku za baadaye.
A father will give you a special gift.
Baba atakupatia kipawa.
A gift of love.
Kipawa cha
upendo. That will go with you.
Ambacho utaenda.
Wherever you go.
Popote unaenda.
A father will give you a special gift.
Baba atakupatia kipawa.
That will give you favor. Wherever you go, Joseph was favored.
Yusuf alipewa.
He was favored.
Alipewa.
When he was sold,
akiwa alipouzwa,
he received favor.
Akapokea.
And he landed in the king's house.
Akapokea kibali, akaingia katika nyumba ya
Potiphar's house.
Katika nyumba ya Potiphar.
Among the slaves, because he was not alone.
Kati ya watumwa manake hakuwa peke yake.
Remember,
kumbuka,
he was a top up.
Alikuwa yeye anaongezewa. Kwa watumwa wengi
that were bought by the Ishmaelites that were passing,
ambao walikuwa wamenunuliwa na Waishmaelites,
but among the men,
lakini kati ya hao
he got favor,
akapata kibali,
to land in Potiphar's house,
akaingia kwenye nyumba ya
Potiphar,
nyumba ya kifalme,
because of the special gift,
kwa sababu ya kipawa
from the father,
kutoka kwa
mama, the gift of love,
kipawa cha
upendo, the gift of favor,
kipawa cha kibali,
the God please receive all the favor God the father had given him.
Lile koti lilisimamia kibali ambacho
baba alikuwa
na. Alikuwa na kibali
za rest of the brothers.
Kati ya ndugu.
And the favor went with Joseph wherever he went.
Alienda nacho popote.
In the prison,
gerezani,
he was favored.
Alikuwa na kibali.
Ah?
Amen.
He was favored.
Alikuwa na kibali.
When you have a father,
wakati una baba,
favor will never part from you.
Kibali hakitakuondokea.
You will ever walk in favor.
Utatembea
kila
wakati.
Praise be to God. When you have a father,
wakati una baba,
you will be covered.
Utafunikwa.
With favor.
Na kibali.
Praise be to God.
Bwana asifiwe.
In Acts chapter 19 and verse 14.
Matendo ya Mitume 19:14-16.
Bible says.
Biblia inasema.
Seven sons of Sceva. Who were Jewish chief priests. Were doing this. What were they doing?
One day.
The evil spirit. Okay. Let them go to verse 13. Let's go back to verse 13 so that we may follow the story. Let us read all of us together, please. Went about, driving out evil spirits, trying to invoke the name of the Lord Jesus, over whom we are demon possessed. They would say, in the name of Jesus, whom Paul preaches, I command you, come out. It makes us get to where the story is coming out, coming from.
Yes.
Praise be to God.
Yes.
Now let's run to verse 15. Verse 15. Let's go now. Let's read together. One day, they must speak as a them.
Jesus,
I know. And I know about Paul. But who are you? What did you do it?
Ili ufanye mabuko.
Tell us first.
Mwambie.
Who's that man?
Wewe ni mwana wa nani?
Yes. You're talking about Jesus.
Unaongea kuhusu Yesu.
Jesus we know.
Yesu tunamjua.
Paul we know.
Paulo pia.
But who are you?
Lakini wewe.
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Verse 16.
Tarasikumnasita.
Verse 16, let us read 1, 2, go.
Then the man who had the evil spirit jumped on them and overpowered them all.
He gave them such a beating that they ran out of the house naked bleeding. Read again. That's a beautiful one. What to go?
Then
the man who had the evil spirit jumped on them and overpowered them all. He gave them such a beating that they ran out of the house naked and bleeding.
Amen.
Who are you?
Wewe ni mwana wa nani?
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
Where are you coming from?
Wewe umetoka wapi?
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Who has sent you?
Umetumwa na nani?
Praise be to God.
Bwana asifiwe.
Praise be to God.
Bwana asifiwe.
Reverend Gekwa, I know.
Mchungaji Gekwa tunamjua.
But who are you? How are you related?
Wewe umeitanishwaje na yeye?
How are you related?
Umeitanishwaje?
Hallelujah.
Abra nikurukie niko.
Jesus I know.
Yes, namjua.
Paul I know.
Paulo namjua.
How to worship and healing I know.
Wewe bado na uponyaji naijua.
Lakini wewe
huko wewe unakuaga nani na sikuoni kwa register? Sikuoni kwa rada.
Kwa register ya Titus.
Sikuoni.
Missing.
Kino mekuja hapa.
Praise be to God. Who are you?
Uganuliwa.
Who are you?
Wewe ni nani?
If you say yourself.
Ukijituma.
That is exactly what will come of you.
Haya ndio yatakayo kutukia.
The seven sons of Sceva.
Vijana wa kiume saba.
They are simple. They are simple.
Wameona Paulo.
Preaching.
Akihubiri.
Casting out demons.
Akifukuza
mapepo. Saying in the name of Jesus.
Saka kwa jina la Yesu.
Receive healing.
Pokea uponyaji.
Get out of him demons.
Toka ndani yake
mapepo. Your right is spiritual warfare.
Anapigana vita vya kiroho.
And he is a telling.
Na anafaulu.
He is a sitting.
Anafaulu.
Like many preachers are doing today.
Kama vile wahubiri wengi
wanafanya.
Utatembea uchi biu.
Don't say I am not one.
Siseme siku kuonya.
Praise be to God.
Bwana asifiwe.
Before you begin that ministry.
Kabla hujaanzisha hiyo huduma.
Before you open that church.
Kabla hujafungua hilo kanisa.
Who is son? Ah, you.
Wewe ni mwana wa nani?
Who is your father?
Baba yako ni nani?
Who is sending you?
Nani amekutuma?
Let me prophesy to you.
Before
Where do you belong?
Wewe una
if we send you home today,
kutuma,
where will you go?
Utaenda wapi?
Amen.
Amen.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
Praise be to God. Utaundwa.
Tapata kichapo.
We are talking of spiritual company.
Tunaongea kuhusu kifuniko cha kiroho.
Amen. And this possessed man.
Mtu mmoja alikuwa na lipepo.
He stands for princes.
Anasimamia utawala.
And the kingdoms.
Na falme.
And authorities.
Na mamlaka.
That reign in the spiritual realm.
Ambazo utawala katika ulimwengu.
When you go to confront.
Unapoenda kukabili.
Without a covering.
Bila kifuniko.
Naked shall you go home.
Oh, utalimwa.
I am telling you, naked shall you go home.
Wewe nyumbani uchi.
Bleeding all over.
Ukiwa unamwaga.
Imagine there are 7 of them.
Vijana saba.
This was only one man.
Wamekula.
But he was possessed.
Jana ni mmoja mwenye pepo.
Hallelujah.
Kawalimu.
But he dealt with them.
Lakini aliwashughulikia. Gozi
kapata. Tear all their clothes.
Nafikiri hiyo nyumba ilikuwa inakaaje wakulimu wao.
Tear all the clothes.
Ili nguo zote zinarudiwe.
And they had to ask their feet to carry them as far as the car they would be carrying them.
Ukipata tu nafasi ya kuchomoka unachomoka kama hauna mkoba.
Are we together? And there is something important I want you to mark here. That these sons of
Skepha.
Skepha was a chief priest.
Alikuwa kuhani mkuu.
He was a
kuhani.
He was a chief.
Alikuwa kuhani mkuu.
Praise be to God. But these sons,
lakini hao,
they had not identified with the ministry and the calling and the anointing and the call and the covering of their father.
Hao wameingia chini ya wito.
They sent themselves. They appointed themselves. Hallelujah.
Mm.
You see the result? I want to warn us.
Nataka kukuone.
Belong.
Itanishwa.
Belong.
Kuwa na mahali itanishwa.
Have a cover.
Kuwa na kifuniko.
And lastly.
Na mwisho.
A father carries your blessings.
Baba anabeba baraka.
Genesis 27 verse 1.
Mwanzo 27
verse 1. Are we there, Genesis? We there? Yes, let's go 35.
When
Isaac was old and his eyes were so weak that he could no longer see, he called for Esau. He, his own, what do you think?
His older brother, his older son,
and saying to him, my son, here I am. He answers. Go on. Isaac saying, I am now man and don't know the day of my death. Huh? Now then, read again. Prepare me. Take the food I like and bring it to me to eat so that I may give you my blessings
before
I die. A father carries your blessings.
Baba, yanae beba baraka yako.
A father carries your blessings. Praise be to God. Praise be to God. A father This is Jacob.
Ni Yakobo.
He is calling his son. His son, Esau, the elder son.
Anaita mwanawe Esau.
Because as a firstborn,
manake kama mzaliwa wa kwanza,
you are entitled to blessing.
Wewe lazima upewe baraka.
But this blessing,
lakini baraka,
must be invoked in you by your father.
Lazima zinenwe juu yako na baba.
Praise be to God. So he calls him. And he gives him direction on how to provoke him to release these blessings. Praise be to God. Now he tells him, remember that Esau was a hunter. Amen. He's calling
wito wake ulikuwa uindaji.
And his brother Jacob, his work was?
Na Yakobo kazi yake ilikuwa ukulima.
Amen. Now before you condemned Jacob,
kabla hujahukumu Yakobo,
I want you to look at these two characters.
Nataka utazame tabia za hawa mawili.
Esau, his work
as yake
is going to go to the field. Get the patent animal.
We tuli kutafuta mnyama
that he gets.
Aliyenona atakayepata.
Amen. What does he do with the animal?
Anafanya nini na ule mnyama?
He saves the animal.
Anamchinja.
And gets a meat from there.
Anapata nyama.
That is Esau. Praise be to God.
Amen.
His work is training.
Huwa kabu.
His work is hunting and
kuinda na kuchinja.
Amen.
Kuwa.
Tuko pamoja. Jacob.
Yakobo.
He was a farmer.
Alikuwa mkulima.
What is the work of a farmer?
Kazi ya mkulima ni ipi?
Amen.
Kulima, kupanda na kuvuna.
I can see many preachers here with the father and his son. Amen. Praise be to God. Get it. You're getting it. You're getting it. Bona sue sana. Praise be to God. And how his work was go get, destroy. And that's it. Amen. From there, nothing will come out of that animal. The match he can get is maybe as the kid.
And That's all.
But Jacob,
lakini ya,
he was dealing with seeds. Somebody who deals with seeds has future.
Mwenye anahusika na mambo ya mbegu ana siku za usoni.
This one gets.
Huyu anapata mnyama mwenye ajui alizaliwa wapi, alilelewa na nani.
The other one gets.
Sinja anakula nyama.
And multiply.
Huyu anachukua mbegu, anaipanda, anajumulisha.
So if he ate pumpkin yesterday.
Kama jana alikula malenge.
After 3 months he can still eat pumpkin.
Baada ya miezi tatu bado anaweza.
Because he will eat the fruit.
Atakula tunda.
But he will plant the seed.
Lakini mbegu atapata.
Praise be to God. That is in your life.
Yo sababu katika maisha yako.
I know we are coming from a place whereby things of the seed have been destroyed in this country.
Ninajua tumetoka mahali mambo ya
ubaya. But I want you to know
vibaya. Lakini
seed time and planting time according to the word of God, it will never cease.
Siku ya kupanda na kuvuna kulingana neno la Bwana haitakoma.
Watu wachukue injili ama wakae. Itaendelea kukua. And it is written.
Na imeandikwa.
Wherever there is seed,
mahali popote kuna
mbegu,
kuna usoni.
A father carries seed.
Baba hubeba mbegu.
Praise be to God. Jacob carried seed.
Yakobo alibeba
mbegu. And he worked with seed.
Na alifanya kazi na mbegu.
That is why.
Ndio ndo sababu.
When the blessing was to be pronounced.
Baraka zilipokuwa zinenwe.
Because he was living a life of seed.
Kwa sababu alikuwa anaishi maisha ya mbegu.
He was to continue because if you are a sin person, you will never die.
Lakini,
you will not come to an end.
Lazima angeendelea.
You have future.
Mbegu, una siku za usoni.
Pray to God. You have future.
Una siku
but because Esau was a terminator.
Lakini kwa sababu Esau kazi yake ilikuwa kumalizia mnyama.
Even his blessings were terminated.
Hata baraka zake zikatoka.
Praise be to God.
Amen.
He